gonna reach my goals. Hello everyone, so in this video I'm going to show how to make this overheaded beat shake effect you just seen on screen. Now the plugins required are Sapphire, BCC and the new Magic Bullet Lux version. I'll leave the Magic Bullet Lux version down in the description, so make sure to download that. And yeah, make sure to like, subscribe, comment and also give me ideas on what effects I should do next, because I'm actually running out of ideas. So if you could leave a comment on what effect I should try to make, that would be nice, and let's start the video. Okay, here we are in Google Drive. These are the presets. This is the whoosh we're gonna use, and then the project file plus clip. That is it. Then moving on to Vegas Pro. This is a clip now, as you can see, I synced it up with the kill. So I'm gonna mark it. Now, I'm just gonna show you how to actually use this preset. Like, this is not a good clip for this preset, because instead of this beat cheek, there should be like a build up, you know, but I'm just gonna show you how to use it. So I marked it here, so when he talks, and I think, you know, that fits, so he talks over here. But yeah, just make a marker on a beat or whatever. So this is, for example, the beat. And then what you want to do is go 30 frames forward. So I'll double click here, backspace plus 30, then I'll mark it. Now make sure the beat is not close, not too close to the kill. So if it's like no over the kill, then it's gonna look weird, and you know it's not even gonna work. So yeah, make sure it's like good distance away from the kill. But anyways, cut it on the first marker, cut it on the second marker we made. Now we're gonna go to effects and then apply Spixio Red Beachy Bottom, add OK. Just like that, and we have something like this. Now we're gonna click U to ungroup it, hold Control, drag this up, just like that. Now you can right click on this effects button, delete all, right? And we're gonna go to pan and crop, so click on pan and crop. And as you can see over here, we're gonna enable masking, and you just wanna basically mask every frame. So I'll show you how I do it on the first frame, and then you can do it on every single frame. So I go on the first frame, I zoom it in, and then I mask. So make sure to mask pretty accurately, but you don't need to be that accurate, and I'll show you why. Okay, so the first mask is done. Now you can go to feather type, set it to both, and then set it to 4. Now you can either set it to like more, so if your edges are like really scuffed, then you can set it to more, but 4 is good. Okay, as you can see, you made your first mask. Now you just want to do this for every single frame, and I'll basically be back when I did it for every single frame. Okay, so here it is. So as you can see, I did some frames and then I skipped some frames, because some frames are not that visible, you know, so you can skip a few frames but don't skip too many. So yeah, this is good. Now we're going to click on this masked clip and then hold Control, drag this up, so to make something like this. And now for the bottom one, or the middle one, go to effects, apply middle, since it's the middle one. And for the top clip, apply top, so beat cheek top, add OK, and you should have something like this. And now you want to fade it in and out, so fade this in by 5 frames. As you can see, it says fade in offset 0.5. same with this, by 5 frames. And now right click on this wave, make it a third option, and make it the third option as well, so this one. And now fade this out by 10 frames, so something like that. And yeah, just do it on both of them, and then right click, third option, right click, third option. And now if I pre-render it, it should look something like this. As you can see, this looks pretty weird, but if you do it on like, you know, a beat cheek, like in the middle of kill, like let's say there's a beat and you do it in the middle of the kill, this might look nice, but yeah, it looks kind of scuffed. But anyways, basically this is the kill. Now you can copy my Twixtor settings if you want, or my preset. So what you should do is go on the kill and then go 30 frames back. So double click here, minus 30, and mark it. So as you can see, this is not really good to do the twixer thingy, but you can still do it. What you can do is just drag this. So just crossface just like that. So, you know, just like that. Then if you go effects, you can apply a Spixy template 30 before. And it should look something like this. Finna reach my goal. Finna reach my goal. Finna reach my goal. Finna reach my goal. That is basically it. Now, as I said, this will look better on like clips that are in the middle. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this tutorial, make sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe. Tell me what tutorial should I do, and yeah, I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.